C'est bien mis l'année, ouais.
Through my fault, through my mistakes,
Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Amen.
proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day the Lord has made. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast, so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our Paschal Lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Christians, to the Paschal victim, offer your thankful praises. A lamb, the sheep redeems. Christ, who only is sinless, reconciles sinners to the Father. Death and life have contended in that combat stupendous. The Prince of Life, who died, reigns immortal. Speak, Mary, declaring what you saw wayfaring. The tomb of Christ, who is living, the glory of Jesus' resurrection, bright angels attesting, the shroud and napkin resting. Yes, Christ, my hope, is arisen. To Galilee he goes before you. Christ, indeed, from death is risen, our new life obtaining. Have mercy, Victor King, ever reigning. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciples went out and came to the tomb. They were found, but the other disciples went faster than Peter
and arrived at the door first. He bent down and saw the burial clothes there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial clothes there, and the clothes that had covered his head. Not with the burial clothes, but rolled up in a secret place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. My brothers and sisters, this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. And we sing with all our hearts, Hallelujah!
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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Christ raised from the dead, brings new life to the world and to us. Because, my brothers and sisters, Easter is the greatest and the most important feast in the church. It marks the birthday of our eternal hope. Easter literally means the feast of the fresh flowers. That's why we celebrate it with pride and jubilation for three reasons. First, the resurrection of Christ is the basis of our Christian faith. For it proves that Jesus is God. That is why St. Paul writes, if Christ has not been raised from the dead, then our preaching is in vain. And your faith is vain. And if Christ has not been raised, then your faith is a delusion. And you are still lost in your sins. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. Hallelujah!
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 In the words of the Catechism of the Catholic Church, the resurrection of Jesus is the crowning truth of our faith in Christ. A faith believed and lived as the central truth by the first Christian community, and then on as fundamental by tradition, established by the documents of the New Testament, and preached as an essential part of the Paschal Mystery, along with the cross. Second, Easter is the guarantee of our own resurrection. Jesus assured Martha at the tomb of Lazarus, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me will live even though he dies. John chapter 11, verses 25 and 26. Christ will raise us up on the last day, but it is also true, in a sense, that we are already risen with Christ Jesus. By virtue of the Holy Spirit, our Christian life is already a participation in the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, our Savior, our Redeemer. Third, Easter is a feast which gives us hope and encouragement in this world of pain, sorrows, and tears. Easter reminds us that life is worth living. It is our belief in the real presence of the risen Jesus in our souls, in his church, in the Blessed Sacrament, and in heaven that gives meaning to our personal as well as to our common prayers. Our trust in the all-pervading presence of the risen Lord gives us strength to fight against temptations and freedom for unnecessary worries and fears. My brothers and sisters, Easter invites us to proclaim the good news that Jesus is alive, alive in our hearts, alive in our homes, alive in our homes, alive in our workplaces. Proclamation and witness bearing are the main themes of today's readings. St. Peter at the house of the Roman centurion Cornelius recounts what was happening all over Judea concerning Jesus. Peter's sermon describes the good deeds of Jesus, who was anointed with the Holy Spirit. But they put him to death by hanging him on a tree. After God raised him from the dead, Jesus appeared to his disciples and commissioning them to preach the gospel. This is what Peter is doing for Cornelius' household. We learn in subsequent verses that the response to Peter's words is to accept the faith and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. In the second reading, St. Paul, bearing witness to his conversion experience of faith in the risen Lord, reminds the Corinthians that Christ is our Paschal Lamb who has been sacrificed for us. This imagery, reminiscent of the first Passover, indicates that the shedding of Christ's blood has redeemed us. In light of this, Paul calls us to live in newness of life, putting aside our old ways and embracing the unleavened bread of sincerity and youth. The passage from John's Gospel takes place on the first day of the week. This is reminiscent of the creation account in Genesis, which narrates the events of creation and the fall in the garden. So now again, God brings life in the garden where Jesus' tomb was located. Mary Magdalene came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark. In John's Gospel, darkness represents a time of lack of faith. Mary is not expecting the resurrection. She comes to mourn the death of Jesus. When she discovers that the tomb was empty, her first thought is that the body of Jesus has been stolen. She returns to the disciples and tells them, "We don't know where they put him." When the two disciples arrive at the tomb, they find it just as she described it. But while Peter seems to not understand, the other disciple saw and believed. He understands what the others will come to know when the risen Christ appears to them. My brothers and sisters, Jesus is risen. The burial clothes that were left behind are not of no need to one who has to get death. We have no burial clothes here. But we do have the bread and the wine that will become the body and blood of our Lord. Easter, my brothers and sisters, is all that speaks in the church here. From that day of resurrection to this most moment and into the future, the disciples of Jesus gather to celebrate and remember the saving events of his death and being raised from the dead. Easter, the feast of the resurrection, gives us the joyful message that we are a resurrection people. This means that we are not supposed to be to lie buried in the tomb of our sins, evil habits, and dangerous addictions. It gives us the good news that no tomb can hold us down any longer. Not the tomb of despair, discouragement, doubt, or death itself. Instead, we are expected to live a joyful and peaceful life, constantly experiencing the real presence of the risen Lord in all the events of our daily lives. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Alleluia! 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 My dear brothers and sisters, the living presence of the risen Lord gives us lasting peace and celestial joy in the face of the boredom, suffering, pain, and the tensions of our day-to-day life. Peace be with you. That the message Jesus brought to his disciples and to us today. For the true Christian, my brothers and sisters, every day must be an Easter day, joyfully in the close company of the risen Lord. We are called to be transparent Christians, showing others through our lives of love, mercy, and compassion, and self-sacrificing service that the risen Jesus is living in our hearts. Our awareness of the all-pervading presence of the risen Lord in and around us, and the strong conviction of our own coming resurrection, help us control our thoughts, desires, wants, and behavior. This salutary thought inspires us to honor our bodies, keeping them holy, pure, and free from evil habits and addictions. Our conviction about the presence of the risen Lord in our neighbors and in all those with whom we come into contact should encourage us to respect them and to render them loving, humble, and selfless service. My brothers and sisters, Easter reminds us that every Good Friday in our lives will have an Easter Sunday, and that Jesus will let us share the power of his resurrection. It's time we display our love of others we share in the resurrection. It's time we face a betrayal of trust and with God's grace forgive the betrayal we share in the resurrection of Jesus. It's time we fall in our attempts to well of ambitions, but keep on trying to overcome them we share in the resurrection. It's time we continue to hope, even when our hope seems unconcerned, we share in the power of Jesus' resurrection. In short, the message of Easter is that nothing can destroy us, not pain, sin, rejection, betrayal, or death, because God has conquered all these. And we too, my brothers and sisters, can conquer them if we put our faith and trust in the resurrected Jesus. Resurrection is good news, my brothers and sisters, but at the same time, it's sometimes painful because it involves death. Before the power of the resurrection can take hold in our lives, we are called to die in sin, to die to self. We may even have to die to our own dreams so that God can do what he wants to do with our lives. Resurrection is about seeing our world in a new way. My brothers and sisters, as we celebrate Easter today, no one and no situation, no matter how terrible, can take the presence of the risen Lord from us. This is the gift of Easter Sunday. May the life of the risen Lord flow through our veins so that every thought, word, and deed of our lives may shine out. Christ is risen. Alleluia. 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 Amen. Now, my brothers and sisters, we renew our baptismal promises. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so, now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounce Satan and his works, and promise to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his temptation?
I do.
Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
do renounce the love of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you.
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the utter embrace of sin?
I do.
And now we proclaim our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace, in Christ Jesus our Lord, for eternal life. Amen. And now we will bless you with the renewal that holy water as a sign of your the renewal of your baptism.
In the water, Jesus.
our Father in heaven, our prayers and petitions.
Lord, hear our prayer. Yeah.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name.
Holy Church.
Be exalted in Pascal, that bless you, Lord. We offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn in the rich to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. At all times we claim you, Lord, but on this day you will fall to love you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the chosen Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world by dying his world our death and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with pastoral joy of your life, we keep all exhausting your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the one and the hymn of your glory as they are praying. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which will make to you, also for those whom you have been pleased to give the new birth of Father and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins, all their obeys in your peace, and command that you be delivered for eternal damnation, and count them on the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took his precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Our merits by begging us your pardon through Christ our Lord. To whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Oh,
unplug it. Unplug it. No, no, sorry. Unplug it back in.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by your paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of your resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. We want to thank our new people, using the talents in the world to give glory and praise to God.
Amen. Amen.
We want to thank our organist, Ja, our twin sisters, during the Holy Week, and to give thanks and praise to God through their songs. I want to thank the lecturers. I want to thank Richard, who put the word of God far away to Zoom. I want to thank the ushers in the church. I want to thank especially Father Delva, who took the time to give away the church. And then I want to bless him that he may continue to be good shepherd in the obedience of the Lord. And thank you, all of you here present, to participate at the great feast of the resurrection of the Lord. May God bless you. Happy serve, and may the light of Christ shine upon you, that you may be the faithful witnesses of the love of God to always dwell among you. Happy Easter. I don't know if you are busy living that day while you're saying this, but they the only guys. Okay. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and His compassion defend you from the wickedness of sin. Amen.
Amen.
And may He restore you to eternal life in the resurrection of His only begotten Son, endow you with the prize of immortality. Amen.
Amen.
Now the days of the Lord's Passion are drawn to a close. May celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy. Amen.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ, alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God, alleluia, alleluia. Once again, happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Christ is risen, alleluia. Thank you.